Hey everyone, it's Corinne. Thank you so much for coming back to my channel. For today's video, I'm going to go over my experience purchasing tax certificate liens at a tax auction in New Orleans, Louisiana. I was literally so scared to start investing in tax certificate liens and had really no clue what I was doing. And it almost cost me big time. Before I jump into the video, don't forget to give this video a like and subscribe to my channel for more real estate related content. I learned about tax auctions a little over a year ago. I wanted to invest in the tax auction last year, but was really scared and just really didn't understand the logistics behind purchasing tax certificates and the legal rights. So I decided to just hold off and wait until this year. And honestly, not much change. I didn't really learn anything else. I think I just gained a little bit more confidence and wanted to take on that risk of buying tax certificate lien. So in a tax auction, a city is able to collect delinquent real estate taxes or property taxes on behalf of a property owner from an investor who is looking to make an investment. In a tax certificate auction, the bid price is fixed at the amount of delinquent taxes plus any associated cost with listing the property at the tax auction. But unlike a traditional auction where the winner is the highest bidder, in a tax certificate auction, the winner is actually the person or investor who is willing to take the lowest percentage of ownership interest in the property. So naturally, the bidding starts at 100% of ownership interest and goes down, and the winner is the person willing to take the lowest percent of ownership interest. Theoretically and in practice, the lowest percentage of ownership is 1%. Regardless of the percentage of ownership you end up obtaining, you are still required to pay 100% of the delinquent taxes plus those associated costs for putting the property up for the tax auction. Now, you might be thinking to yourself, what's in it for the investor who is paying these delinquent taxes on behalf of the property owner? The investors can't just take ownership of the property after paying off the property owner's delinquent taxes. The property owner has 3 years, otherwise known as the redemptive period, to either pay back the investor with interest, or the investor is able to quiet the title and take ownership of the property after that 3-year redemptive period. In return for the investor paying this property owner's taxes, the property owner would have to pay back the investor everything that the investor paid, plus 5%, plus 1% per month that the owner doesn't pay back the investor. So after a 3-year period, if the owner pays back at the last second before the redemptive period ends, the investor can make up to a 41% return on their initial investment. One important thing to note though is that it is required of that investor to pay the subsequent year's taxes. Otherwise, the property is just going to fall back into the tax auction again. If the owner of the property doesn't redeem the property and pay back the investor within that 3-year redemptive period, the investor with that ownership interest can then quiet the title and take over ownership of the property. So this year, the list of properties came out and I really did my due diligence. I cross-referenced the assessor's website and I looked at parcel maps and I looked at Google images and I even checked the MLS for previous listings that might have photos of the inside, because my fear was that I would purchase a tax certificate that was higher than the actual value of the real estate itself. And that is especially true for vacant lots. I didn't want to purchase a tax certificate that wouldn't be worth as much as the lot was worth after the 3-year redemptive period if the owner didn't pay me back. So the bidding started at 8 a.m. on July 21st and went until 8 p.m. on July 23rd. So right before 8 a.m. I opened up my computer, and right when it hit 8 a.m. I started bidding on all of the properties that were in my watch list. And it was such an adrenaline rush to see that I won a couple properties at 100%, and that I'd been outbid on couple properties because someone had clicked on it a half a second before I did. So going through that process was really fun and thrilling, but I had to get ready for work that morning and just decided to close my computer and revisit the site in a couple hours. So after a couple hours, I opened up my computer again and wanted to see which properties I was still the winning bidder on. And I think I was winning 3 or 4 properties. So I was the investor that was willing to take the lowest percentage of ownership on those 4 properties. And before going back in and placing bids on properties that I'd already been outbid on, I decided to just cross-reference one last time and make sure that the properties that I had been winning on were actually properties that I wanted. So as I was looking through the properties that I had the winning bid on, it came to my attention that I had accidentally or unintentionally bid on a horrific piece of land. It was a 900 square foot landlocked piece of land in the middle of a block, and I felt my stomach drop because I really didn't want to buy 900 square feet of land, which was surrounded and inaccessible, and I had no idea what to do. Thankfully, I have a friend who has a friend that works for the company who facilitates the tax auction, and they were able to take that property off my watch list and remove my bid. But that was such a scary experience because I had a feeling that that property owner would not have redeemed the property, and I really just would have lost a lot of money on that investment. So I'm so thankful to have that bid removed from my watch list. But moving on from that experience, I did place bids on some other properties, and I'm actually really excited about those two. I think I got one of them for almost $1,800 at a 38 or 39% interest, ownership interest in the property. And then the other one was about $1,900 for a 35% ownership interest in the property. I'm really excited to see if those property owners pay back their taxes and at which point too, because every month that goes by is another percent of interest that I get on those properties. But I'm really hoping that these owners don't pay back their taxes and that at the end of 3 years, I'll be able to quiet the title and redeem those properties and be able to resell those properties for a lot more money than I originally invested by paying off these people's taxes. If you are considering purchasing tax certificate liens at a tax auction, I would highly recommend that you do your research and make sure that you are not investing in a property that is worth less than the money you're putting into it to pay off the delinquent taxes. I almost did that, and that was with my heavy research and extensive due diligence. If New Orleans is a city that you are looking to invest in, feel free to reach out. I'll leave all my contact information down below. But other than that, if you like this video, give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel for more real estate related content.